Hi, my name is Takaya Williams, Unique Williams. I will be reading Stop, Drop, and Roll by Margaret Kyler, illustrated by Arthur Howard. Jessica was a worrier. She worried morning, noon, and night. She worried about her spelling homework and learning new steps in ballet class, and remembering to fill her dog's water dish and waking up in time for school. But on Monday morning in October, Jessica's teacher gave her something new to worry about. Fire Prevention Week, explained Mr. Martin. So for the next few days, we're going to talk about fire safety. Uh-oh, groaned Jessica. And this Friday, Mr. Martin continued, we've been asked to share with what we've learned with the entire school. Oh no, moaned Jessica. Let's begin with smoke alarms, said Mr. Martin. Your homes should have them on every floor. Automatic fire sparkles are a good idea too. Smoke alarms, sprinklers, Jessica had never seen anything in her house. Her family should also have escape plans in case of a fire, said Mr. Martin, and fire drills so everyone knows what to do. Jessica chewed her pencil in half. Escape plans now? She was really worried. That night, Jessica announced, this is a big problem in this house. We have no smoke alarms and no sparklers. 16. We don't even have an escape plan. If there was a fire, we'd be in trouble. Her mother perked her forehead. I remember buying smoke alarms, but I guess we never got around to installing them. And we talked about finding someone to put in sparklers, added Dad, but we're always too busy to make an appointment. And what about extra batteries for the alarms, reminded Laurie. Yeah, said Tom. We need to keep more batteries around here. Oh, sorry guys, I ain't show you this page. Sorry. I just read this page. Jessica twisted her napkin. She knew the real reason Tom wanted more batteries around. His birthday was in 3 days. He wanted batteries for his present, but fire safety was more important than birthday toys, wasn't it? We've got to do something about this now, warned Jessica. You're right, said Mom. After dinner, we'll make escape plans and find those smoke alarms. And tomorrow, I'll get extra batteries and make some arrangements for a sparkless Simpson, said Dad. But Jessica still felt too worried to sleep. She tossed and turned all night. The next day, Mr. Martin wrote some fire safety rules on the blackboard. Never play with lighters or matches. Keep electric heaters at least 3 feet away from things that could burn. Keep extension cords away from doorways and from being pinched by furniture. A profession should check the chimneys and furnaces in your homes each year. Blah blah blah. Mr. Martin went on and on until Jessica had to cover her ears. She'd never be able to remember so many things. At dinner, Jessica asked, "Have you ever had a chimney checked?" "Yes," answered Dad. "When you bought the house, but Mr. Martin said it would be checked every year," said Jessica. The furnaces too," Dad signed. "I'll put them on my list of things to do." But they didn't stop Jessica from ordering. She went through the entire house checking cords and smoke alarm batteries, and she had another sleepless night imagining all the things that could go wrong. On Wednesday, Mr. Martin had even more fire safety rules. He makes smoke rise, so if you're in a fire, you must crawl under the smoke when the air is cleaner. And when you reach a door, touch it. If it feels cold, it's safe to open. Jessica tugged at a burrito. "What if the door felt warm? What should I do then?" "If the door is warm," continued Mr. Martin, "don't open it. Find a window and call for help. Then wait for a firefighter to come and tell you what to do." "And there's one more very important thing you need to know," said Mr. Martin. "If your clothes catch fire, stop you're doing. Drop to the ground and roll around and roll over and over until you smother the flames." Catch fire, Jessica had never been so worried in her life. "Stop, drop, and roll," repeated Mr. Martin. "Let's all say it 3 times. Stop, drop, and roll. Stop, drop, and roll. Stop, drop, and roll," chanted the class. All except Jessica. Her worries had twisted her tongue into a big knot. When Jessica got home, she made her family have a fire drill. Then she rechecked all the electrical cords, tested their batteries and all the smoke alarms, and made double sure that there were no matches laying around. Afterwards, Jessica felt a little better, but she still couldn't get Mr. Martin's words from the class right. "Stop, slop, and troll, mop, pop, and bowl." The harder Jessica tried, the worse she did. But she went to sleep feeling a little better. At least she knew what to do if there was a fire during the night. Then on Thursday, disaster struck. Mr. Martin asked Jessica to demonstrate stop, drop, and roll at the admissibly the next day. "Why me?" thought Jessica. On the bus, she tried to practice the words stop, flop, and roll, flop, mop, and stroll, stop, pop, and hold, but they kept coming out wrong. Jessica was so worried about the invincibility that she couldn't even enjoy Tom's birthday party. Stop, drop, and mold, slop, drop, and hold. plot mop and troll, she muttered to herself. Because of all her muttering, she didn't even notice when Mom's butt indicated. It had 7 big candles on it. 6 were for Tom's 6th birthday, and 1 was for his wish on it. And 1 was for him to wish on. And just as Tom leaned over to blow them out, Jessica looked up and saw fire. Stop, drop, and roll. Immediately, Tom stopped blowing and dropped to the floor. But before he rolled, Jessica saw that Tom wasn't on fire at all. Jessica's words had gotten the best of her. She was so embarrassed. False alarm said that. Phew, Simone, you gave me quite a scare. I'm sorry, said Jessica, but I thought you thought quickly, interrupted Dad. That's good, because it's better to be safe than sorry. Besides, added Laura, you finally said it right. And that was the truth. Jessica had said the words right, and now that she was confided, she never forgot any of the first fire safety rules. She had learned that week, and you know what? She never did. Stop, drop, roll. The end. Thank you for having me to read Stop, Drop, and Roll. Have a nice day.